What is power electronics? Researchers, books, and many references define power electronics as a hybrid technology that involves disciplines of power and electronics. But why should we define it as a standalone discipline? Let's start the story from the beginning, when the first traditional power station was built around 140 years ago. The traditional power system consists of three main parts. The power stations, which are designed to operate huge generators that are spinning all the time to produce electricity with AC current. This electricity is transmitted through the second part of power system, which is the transmission lines, to supply the third part, which is presented in houses, industry, or what we call the loads. But where is electronics here? Or why do we need electronics? In recent years, there are loads of emerging and distributed energy resources are coming to the traditional power system, such as renewable energy resources. For example, photovoltaic panels produce clean but unregulated DC energy. Wind turbines also produce clean but unregulated AC energy. The question is, how to include and integrate these new resources to the traditional power system? We need electronics that can tolerate high power. When we think about electronics, devices like transistors, diodes, and passive components come to our mind. Yes, power transistor, which is different than the normal transistor, and power diode, which is also different than the normal diode. Also, the inductors must tolerate high current, and the capacitors must be able to handle high voltage levels. Actually, power electronics is all about the conversion of electric power in a controlled manner using switching devices. Switching is something very important in power electronics. We usually use this symbol to define a switch. This switch can be any power electronics device that can condition the required power. Switching devices can be transistors such as IGBTs or MOSFETs, can be thyristors or power diodes, and many other devices. We'll talk about switching devices in another video. It's very important now to know that the power range of these devices can be something from a few watts, similar to what we use in power banks and mobile chargers, to several gigawatts, and that is usually handled in high power systems such as high voltage DC grids. It's also important to note that power electronics is different from signal electronics, where the power ranges in signal electronics can be from nanowatts to a few watts only. Signal electronics can be the electronics used in telecommunications, wireless communications, transmitters and receivers, digital electronics, analog electronics, and amplifiers. All these are not power electronics. We will also talk about how to differentiate between power electronics and other types of electronics in another video. One advantage of power electronics is that operating the power in a switching mode can achieve high efficiency. This efficiency can be something from 96 to 99%. This makes 1 to 4% losses only. 1% losses in high power electronics means a huge amount of power. So if we manage to save small fractions, that's a big saving. Also, power electronics devices can easily be cooled if you compare them to analog or digital electronics. There are many topics to enjoy talking about. Next time, we will talk about the mode of conversions in power electronics. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and thanks very much for watching.